Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to be talking about intonation and finger combinations. These two subjects I wanted to do in one video because they're quite related. It's pretty complicated to explain which finger combination should you choose in which situation. There are a couple of things that you need to consider. For me, there are two things which make a difference. Intonation, the quality of slurs. Here you can see the finger chart which I normally use. I mostly play on the B-flat side of the horn, especially when I'm performing, with an exception in the second octave, there is an area which you cannot do on a B-flat side, you have to play it on F-side. It's another story when I practice. I actually practice quite a lot on the F-side, especially scales. The benefit of that is that the F horn has a lot more resistance and it is easier to train your muscles. Now, going back to the two reasons which influence my choice of fingerings, the second one is easiest to explain, the quality of the slurs. A good example is that I play the fourth octave G always on the F side open because the intonation of that note is a lot better. The G on the B-flat side with first finger is way too low. When I need to slur that G to the F-sharp half a tone below, I mostly play the F-sharp on the F-side with the second finger. Now you will listen to two different versions of the slur between G and F-sharp. In the first one, I play the F-sharp on the B-flat side, and in the second one, I play it on the F-side. Let's go on to the second reason, intonation. This is quite complicated to explain, and I'm gonna start with an example. Listen to the two versions of the same chord, and afterwards I'm going to explain to you what I did differently. The only difference between these two chords was the major third. In the first version, I play the major third on the B-flat side with the second finger, and in the second version, I played it on the F-side open. The rule with triads is that the third has to be low. Now listen to another example. The first one I will play in just intonation, and change the valve combinations. In the second one, I will play it all with one valve combination, also better known as the natural harmonic series. I hope that you noticed that there were some differences in the intonation. This is the guide which you have to follow to find the right finger combination to make sure that the chord is in tune. What you can do is play out the natural harmonic series with all the different finger combinations and search for the notes which are naturally low and sharp. Another thing that you should consider is balance. To make sure that the triad is in tune, not only the third has to be low, but it also has to be a little bit more quiet than the rest of the voices. Now you will listen to the A major triad. In the first version, I'm playing the third on the B flat side with fingers 2 and 3, and in the second version, I'm playing it on the F side with fingers 1 and 2. As you heard in the second version, it blended just a little bit better with the rest of the voices. That is because on F horn, it is a lot easier to play quietly. I'm going to give you one more example. This is going to be the B-flat triad. I hope this rule is now clear for you. Explore and find out new finger combinations. That was it. I hope this video helped you. If you enjoyed it, please smash that like button and subscribe to be the first to know when a new video is released. Have a good day.